and welcome to this very special episode of By the Wave News Mobile. And nothing could be better to be here in this discussion with people who actually play a very important role in making us what we are, our teachers. And it is my privilege to have four very accomplished teachers here with me who are going to be discussing with us, giving us their perspective and telling us what is it to be a teacher in times like today.
The techniques involved and the technology involved was really frightening. You know, you're so used to entering into the class and, you know, asking the one of the kids, you know, the smartest one with the gadgets or something, you know, to help you out with the PPT, the videos and everything. And you would have hundreds of helpers around, you know, arranging things for you and things like that. And the things would be so easy and things like that. And so here online, suddenly you are all alone. You know, you have to manage that video, you have to manage that PPT, you have to ensure that your questions are there, you know, the students are paying attention. Then initially it was so difficult to understand whether you've met that objective, whether the child has understood, you know, checking, then how would I make my exam? Oh God, test again, you have to go for a training and things like that. So it was really, you know, it was mind-blowing, or what do you say?
How do you make kids of that age, you know, Falguni, you've got primary kids, nursery kids, how do you make them engaged on a screen where, you know, they can just do anything?
Yeah, it's very difficult to, you know, bring their attention because they are at no more studies. We are just getting bored. Ma'am is also getting bored. So keep away your crayons and all, and let's just jump. Let's just clap, let's just scream our hearts out. And, you know, these kind of activities really cheer them up. Over the period of this 4-5 months, it's been that we had built a connect with the parents, and we have always been telling them that if the child is not willing to sit in front of the camera, it's fine. Don't constrain them. Let them be in the room. Let them have that space. Because classroom was one place where they had a lot of space to move around. And for these kids, it's very challenging, you know, at this time to sit like for half an hour and listen to ma'am on the screen.
On this new word, which they call the technical glitch. And they say the technical glitch. So yes, if the frequency is too high, the teachers do have a knack of catching those children, particularly the ones who are having too many technical glitches. And the genuine ones you do get to know. Because if the child has been slipping away, particularly when the question has been asked. So I know that was not a technical glitch. So we do have our own ways to get to know them. Group that I teach is 8-9-year-olds, and they are very energetic. So in the physical classroom, I literally have to scream in order to be heard. And that becomes like a little challenge. But here the simplest thing is mute all.
When I initially just joined, I was a month old in the organization, and I was warming up to kids and teaching in general. And, you know, kids were, we would ask each other questions just to warm up. And these kids found out that I watched Game of Thrones. And that's about the time towards the end of the month is when season 6, I believe, had come out. So now I walk into class this one day, and you know how in the US it's released a day earlier. And then Monday morning is when you could view it. So I'd normally go home and catch the episode, except these kids would wake up early, catch it, and come to school. And so they told me if they're not left early, they're going to disclose what happens in that particular episode. And I actually had to leave them early. So, you know, little things like this, the thought of them, if you really get down to it, I miss the physical space. I miss being in school. Nothing can replicate that. Nothing, absolutely nothing. Online, it has been challenging. It's been comfortable also, to say the least. But nothing can replace being with the children in a physical space. Nothing at all.
Yes, I totally do agree. Yes, there is a strong connect that we need to build with the children, even more so now with the times that are emerging and the physical space not being really met. There is this challenge of me actually getting to know the child. And like Sadej just said, we also began our academic year with not meeting this bunch of children. So it's tough to actually penetrate into a child's heart, 8-9 year old, if you've not physically met. But then what I do is I initiate a week where children are sharing their real life stories. It could be something that they did on the weekend, something which is close to their heart, any new hobby that they're pursuing.
For our age group children, it is mostly they rely on they feel confident when they are in the classroom. They feel confident looking at the teacher's face that yes, I'm in the right direction. But when they are at home, they need a support because it's a digital medium. They need a support to answer, and at times it happens that they are not clearly hearing what the question is. So they at times they rely on their parents, and their parents repeat the question for them. But you know what happens is that we as teachers, we make an effort if we observe that for a particular child, a parent is constantly repeating the answers or making him or her answer it, then we have to politely say that, parents, please don't help. Let the child answer. If it is wrong, right, it doesn't matter. It's just that how confidently he or she is answering.
Emotions probably remain the same over the generations. The only thing is, you know, the surroundings, the technology, the way it is expressed or something, it really has changed, of course. You know, it's difficult to understand, for example, how could you become so friendly with this mobile or the gaming, or, you know, why, you know, that image on that Instagram is so important, and, you know, where was that last party held, and, you know, it's difficult to understand and get across. There probably a change has happened where, you know, the child has that pressure of being on that Instagram also, having, you know, getting his friends, watching him or her or something like that.
I think there's been immense change. So I remember when I look back as my days as a student, I think things were very, very different. The kids are exposed to so much today. There's information galore. We don't know how to track it down. And it's overwhelming for them. And of course, mental health has come to the fore because of this information overload and the lack of ability to be able to handle so much that's been put on their plate. I was talking to my class yesterday. They do feel lonely. You know, their parents are at home, but they're busy. The economy is in slowdown. I mean, everyone's stressed. The mood is low. And of course, as teachers and as a school, we are pitching in with mentoring programs and all of that. But at the end of the day, they miss that physical space. They miss meeting their peers. You know, having a teacher, that physical connect is immensely missed even by students.
How were you as a student?
I never wanted to study, truly speaking. I always wanted to be, jitni chutti ho jaye utni achhi hai. But that's how I was when I was young.
To say the least, I mean, I was at one point till middle school very, very involved with theatre and activities. And then I completely transitioned into this geeky kid who was very, very focused. So I've had a very boring, and now that I look back, I feel like I tell my parents I should be grateful for a child like this. Because I've only had good things said about me at that level, but I regret it. So, you know, when I meet my kids, I always talk to them about my school. I'm like, have fun, guys. This time's not going to happen.
I was a very shy kid, very, very shy. So much so that many teachers did not know me. But because I was the eldest with my cousins, so eventually they got to know, she belongs to this family.
What do you think, behind your back, your students call you? Is there a pet name you think your students have for you?
Miss Candy.
Mine is a diary, because I often would collect all their diaries, you know, to give them notes if they wouldn't do their homework and things like that.
The kids find me very, very, they used to call me Sassy Sadhya, but I didn't take well to that. It was Gutsy Sadhya, because I think they just feel like I'm... they think I'm unfiltered, though I think I'm very, very filtered in the school. So I don't know where it comes from, but gutsy. They also think our mental, they also tell me mental age matches, ma'am. I don't know where it comes from, but they believe my mental age is 16.
Before we end this, one last line, if you have to say that this teacher's day, I wish what for my students? cool.
This Teachers Day, I would really want all my children back to the class. I want them to see them run in the green grass, play freely and enjoy their life to the full and not constrain themselves into these four walls.
I mean, these are some of the best years of your life, and I think I want them to have the maximum fun they could have. You know, this is the age where you're so innocent and so naive. You don't have to worry about your responsibilities or something like that, and enjoy and have the best years of your life. That's it.
Like Sadeh said, childhood doesn't come back, and these are the years that they must enjoy to the fullest. And they must sometimes, as a teacher, I can't say this in school, but I can say it here. Yes, they must bunk classes some days. It's okay.
I missed out on record. We've got you on record now, Preeti, to say that.
Sometimes submit the assignments late. It actually happens with your teachers too. But childhood is something which will never, never, never come back. So make memories, enjoy life, be healthy, and come back and give us free hugs.
When this is over, may we never take again for granted a handshake with a stranger, conversations with neighbors, a crowded theater, Friday night out, a routine checkup, the school rush every morning, coffee with a friend, the stadium roaring, each deep breath, a boring Tuesday, a mundane Thursday, life itself. When this ends, may we find that we've become more like the people we wanted to be, we were called to be, we hoped to be, and may we stay that way, better for each other because of the world.
Really, it's tough to be a teacher. It's also loving and fun to be a teacher. And thank you so much for all the effort that you put in shaping our kids to be what they are in the future. A very, very happy Teacher's Day to all of you.
Thank you.